speak.
The disc appears in your mind's eye. Lae'zel sees it too and considers the vision.
Tissue markings. Ancient. I recognize them, but I can't make sense. No. Wait. The texts are enciphered, but I've solved the pattern. It's a story. About Orpheus.
Your head buzzes in concert with Lae'zel's, but it hardly matters. Even without the connection, you'd recognize her discomfort.
Githyanki writing. Every word a wheel. Every letter is spoke. The most powerful texts are engraved in slate. Some so ancient, only the most erudite Gish can read them. A traitor. A dead one. This text is heresy. I can hardly bear to read it, let alone speak it. Very well. I will read it to you. The Prince of the Comet, Part 1. So it was that we were free from Geish shackles and turned our blades on each other. The heavens were shattered, and one great empire was divided in two. Gith traveled to the Hells to broker help for her people, her cause. Vlakith would have you believe Mother Gith proclaimed her our queen. Lies. Gith made no such proclamation. Vlakith seized the Empire against the Mother's wishes. But Gith had nurtured a son, Orpheus, Prince of the Comet, the true heir. He knew Vlakith's treachery. Orpheus rallied Gith's honor guard and declared the throne for himself. The War of the Comet had begun. Disregard this drivel. Gith declared Vlakith queen of the Empire, and her own son defied her. Orpheus would have ceded control to the Geish. And so it is, a fabrication. A clever one, too, to masquerade as an ancient history. How many such stories could there be? And how many minds have been warped by them?
I greet you, child of the sun. How has your search for the mushrooms fared? These are fine specimens. It will only take me a moment to brew them to proper potency.
Omeluum turns away to prepare the potion, lost in its own musings.
You must drink the entire draught. I can make no promises as to its taste. It will lower the psionic defenses around the lava. If I cannot remove it, I may still be able to tell you more about its origin.
Omeluum watches you with cautious intensity. It expects doubt. It expects fear.
Only in that you may be a danger to yourself. What the potion may make you see or feel, I cannot determine. But unless you are already a step from death, it will not kill you.
The potion is disgusting beyond description. The only mercy is that it goes down quickly.
Not a drop left. Very good. As the potion influences your mind, you may find yourself acting irrationally. Try and stay focused.
The world loses its edges, its finer boundaries. You are fluid, but trapped like a creature suspended in amber. holes bite at the edges of your vision, but the void cannot draw you in. The temple spasms, seizes. It's fighting the potion even harder than you are. Fear pierces your mind like knives of ice. The parasite digs deeper, as if it means to hollow out your skull. Stalwart, turning that tide of fear against itself. The parasite swells with power, more power than you have ever felt before. It surges and twists, lashing out against that which would dare to intrude. The parasite in your mind quiets, pleased with itself.
Omeluum, are you well?
That lava is like nothing I have ever observed before. Its power is unsettling. Such an outcome was not in my calculations. There is more to this being than mere stasis. Yet that power may grow beyond your control. I have another intermediate solution, if you are in need. I possess a ring of mind shielding. It prevents elder brains from noticing my presence. It will not remove the lava, but it will limit its influence, both positive and negative. I would offer it as a gift, but in truth, the ring is priceless. Is there anything you could offer me in turn? A fascinating topic indeed. What can you tell me? What a brilliant experience, to feel one step closer to my ancestors is a fine gift indeed. Here, it is yours. May it serve you as well as it has served me.
That thing better work. If it doesn't, I doubt you'll be in any position to complain.
Of course, the lava remains. Be ever vigilant of its growth. I have never seen anything like that.
Traffic. mind, never quiet.
Boots have seen everything. That should work.
Oh.
worth the cost.
Thank you. close ahead.
Breathing, despite everything.
There's no time to waste. Take you.
No one stopped me yet.
Take you.
Intestines throb, blood whispers.
Corpse regards you lifelessly.
Dawn! House! Bartle! Graven Hollow! Scholar! Sargrim! Argument! Summoned spectator! Memory! Lae'zel activates Dawn, Lord Archmage. Choose way to adamantine forge. He wanted memory shard. Menso Baranson. Searching. Forge. Adamantium. Precious beyond measure.
Right tool will do the trick.
Bunch of empty boxes and spider webs. Guess Lolth's cultists haven't been back here in a while.
Fill your oceans, O blessed Boal. Our bones to build your temple in the deep.
A wave of pure devotion washes over you, and with every surge, you feel a presence grow in response.
Word, priest, promises. Your god wants proof, wants blood.
Beings of Kuatoa, former Mind Flayer slaves that manifest their gods through sheer belief.
You! Our Lord of Murder demands sacrifice! You will be an offering for the great god Boal!
Well placed! Boal wants a sacrifice! What's that then? What you got for blessed poor? Sounds like a lot more blood, a lot more mess. Good. Go with my blessing, Chosen. Tell the world that Boal is coming. Show them my power. But Chosen, just don't forget where you got it from.
Mad guilt swills in your swooning sick body. Today you became the tart of a false god, and your evil pride revolts.
Watch how you go. There's a trap. Right tool will do the trick.
Thank you.
down.